So to begin with, what I would like to invite all the participants. So I'm Dr. Yakaya, teacher educator by profession, and interested in teaching and empowering the all those concerned with teaching learning process, wherein we, the teacher educators, the teachers, and our most valuable learners are concerned. So as a part of this activity, as you are aware, Teacher Education SS platform has been organizing a series of lectures, and this particular activity, as you are aware, under LOD, lecture on demand, in the last before week, those of you have attended, and I'm sure you will be able to recollect that we have discussed how to choose a topic. If some of you have attended already, or otherwise also you have a topic ready with you, just please type in the chat, either MED or BA topic, your name, MED or BA, and what is the topic of that. Because as you know, as a part of research work, at the steps in the process of research, the first step is the selection of the topic. If topic is not selected, if you haven't finalized the topic, the question of going to review of related literature does not make any meaning or relevance. By the way, if you are not ready with one, don't worry. And what I want to tell you is, if you are a MED candidate or a PhD or at any level research student, MA education or MED or PhD, if you have decided already on a topic, just type your name, level of education, that is B.Ed, MA education, M.Ed, MA education or PhD, and your topic. So because if the topic is ready here, while I discuss about this review of related literature, I will refer your topic and we will be discussing. For whatever the practical reasons or the otherwise constraints or limitations, we are very small number of us are here, that's okay. It's not the question of number for us. And this is how we understand this. We are creating digital resources, and this will be available as we share on the various platforms of Teacher Education SS, YouTube, and other channels, and others required may be seeing. Now, for you, the additional benefit and advantage for being online, for taking out your time on this Sunday, like other students and lecturers or the other candidates, you also might have had several things to do this holiday evening, Sunday evening, but you made it. So the advantage for you is, if you just type in the topic name, if you have chosen already, if you are working on it, or if you propose to work, I invite you, type your topic here. And at appropriate time, while explaining, it's not just theoretical presentation today. What I have planned is, so practically we are going to see, do that. We are going to review the literature for a few sample topics. And if you write, and it will be advantageous for you also. So I can take up your topic and live do it practically. How do we do? So meanwhile, if you, by the time you type, and let me start with some introduction to review of related literature, for which I have prepared a small PowerPoint presentation. And let me share my screen. I will be able to share my PPT, and with the help of which we'll be able to move forward. All right. So here is the PPT. Hope you are able to see this.
Yes, sir.
Let me expand so that conveniently you can see. Yeah, hope you could see the full screen now.
Yes,
yes. Review of related literature and sample selection for research. So here the last topic we have, the dissertation. Let us say this dissertation topic, or your PhD or other level of research, PG level of research topic is with you. Or if you do not have, just think of something in the upcoming research endeavor, what the topic that you would like to do. So I'm Dr. Yakaya. Here is my email ID. And probably for the purpose of this research guidance, only through this particular channel, I'll be serving you. And for other general queries or research queries, you may type in, depending on the possibility, I can respond. Okay, if required, other in that case only. All right, so why and what of review of related literature? Literature review is an integral part of entire research process. Now, can we think of any research work without review of related literature, be it a quantitative or qualitative, be it in education, social sciences, or pure sciences? And if you are a researcher and claiming that there is no review of related literature in my area, which is a topic not under the sun? Because almost all the topics under the sun are research. Some are widely, thoroughly researched. A lot of review of related literature exists. A few new, innovative, or less researched, but at least definitely their predecessor. Suppose if you talk about 21st century learners, already 20 years have gone. Now, in the last 20 years, there is a research on 21st century learners, new gen learners. If you talk about COVID-19, I think these days, almost all faculties, including social sciences, pure sciences, medicine, law, every faculty thoroughly doing research on COVID-19 and post effects and so on and so forth from their perspective. So if you name any topic, definitely there exists some research so far have conducted. Maybe formal, informal, maybe published, unpublished, maybe directly or indirectly. So therefore, there is no topic of research worth doing which doesn't have any relevance or related literature having under the sun. So the question is, now we have to identify. And at this juncture, let me invite you, if any of you think, sir, I have a topic in my mind, or I know some topic which did not have review at all, just you can unmute and respond, let us discuss, or else you can type in the chat, let me take up that, and then we will go ahead. All right, I just come back for the chat, and I don't see any typing coming in the chat. Otherwise, those who are in live, if you want to unmute and say, sir, this is the topic I think, or I'm thinking, nothing wrong if you think so, by the way, don't worry. Not much review of related literature be available. I'll be more happy to note that and to start with that topic probably, so that if you could do a review of related literature to a topic for which review is not available or not much is available, and for any other topic, review of literature will be available. Otherwise, typically in our educational research, normally if you refer to any awarded thesis, second or third chapter, mostly second, it's not the five chapters should be there, PhD, by the way, but in general, in my observation, most of the thesis where five chapters are organized, typically it goes first the introduction, second review of related literature, third chapter the methodology, and then the fourth chapter analysis and interpretation, fifth chapter that's findings, conclusions, suggestions, and so on and so forth. By the way, I'm not suggesting a research report should have five, but these five aspects to be covered, it could be in five chapters, seven chapters, 10 chapters, or 15 chapters. All these five aspects are covered accordingly. There will be at least one chapter or more than one chapter on review of related literature. Now, some of you might have seen the thesis where there is no exclusive chapter for review of related literature. Yes, I also note that and understand that, where some people will combine the introduction, theoretical conceptual framework, and review of related literature, and covered in the first chapter itself. That's okay. But there will be a review of related literature as an integral part of the thesis. Yeah, I only just have minimized the PowerPoint for you to see whether you, any of you are sharing anything in the chat or any discussion question comes there. All right, as we have quite limited number of people, I invite your actively participation through discussion. All right, that can engage more. The second point here you could note is it makes significant contribution to each and every operational step at later stage. Now, review of related literature, it's not just limited to that one chapter or two chapters as an exclusive chapter meant for reporting reviews you have kept. For your kind information, a thorough review of related literature will be helpful even in enriching your first chapter, that is introductory chapter, theoretical framework of the research. If you could recollect, some of you who have attended my previous session and selection of the topic, I was mentioning you have to do a review of related literature, preliminary review of related literature, first round of review of related literature, even before you finalize your topic, so that you will come to know what is happening in that area, what work is done so far, what is reported, what is the research, further research need, what is the gap in the research, that is which area is not yet covered, so that you can, if you are interested in that broad area, take up that gap or that piece of not covered work for your research. All right? And then, after passing through this stage, a researcher is able to acquaint oneself. Now, when you have the topic, probably your broad interest is in your mind. When you have framed your objectives also, still only a significant part of the topic is familiar to you. But when you do the review of related literature, the real wide scope of that particular topic will come. Why? Because other people have seen from their own perspective, from different angles. They have thrown light on different frameworks related to that particular topic. Let us say emotional intelligence is the topic. Now, emotional intelligence, though, is one of the new and recently coming to light and lot of research being carried out. You have several theories of emotional intelligence apart from Goldman. What different perspectives? Emotional intelligence is pursued by behaviorists, by cognitive psychologists, by constructivists. Again, it differs. So when you refer to different kinds of researchers and their works and that particular concept from the point of view of the present study which you have taken up or which you propose to conduct, that will give you a good acquaintance, a thorough knowledge, an outline and information about. Okay, able to acquaint oneself with the available body of knowledge in the area of interest. All right, and then why? What other reasons are there for review of related literature? The literature review is a critical look at the existing research that is significant to work that you are carrying out. Otherwise, without, what happens after 1 or 2 years of working and fine day you happen to see in one journal or magazine or a textbook or a published report comes out stating that what you have proposed to work was carried out by somebody and the result have come. So therefore, review of related literature is an important part to begin with before you start your work, while your work is in progress, and at the end. But now somebody may come, sir, there is no rule in this wide area of a country like India or abroad. Somebody may be doing on the same topic. That's okay, nothing wrong, but methodology, variables, sample, all those should not be the one and the same. Maybe your framework, your point of view, or the variables, the sample, the angle of your study. Be different, that's okay. That's not there what to do. If they have already published and it makes sense, you to modify your research framework. If required, you need to go for change of the topic or objectives, variables accordingly. So therefore, it is important, not only just one time activity, just before your submission of the thesis or at just beginning of your proposal work, review of related literature is an ongoing activity. If you do so, what happens? It helps to provide background information to establish importance of that particular topic. Recently, one of my students have done on that emotional intelligence and academic achievement. And then what is the importance of emotional intelligence on academic achievement? Now, earlier we have seen the academics and curricular and co-curricular. Okay, two wings, related we thought, but it's not related, they are integral. And rather constructivist approach goes beyond and says your socio-cultural experiences are converted into learning experience. So therefore, your social experiences, day-to-day living experiences are an integral part, rather foundation, base for the learning activity. So therefore, review of related literature will help us to understand the background information, to establish the importance of that particular topic, and to demonstrate familiarity. So you as a researcher are going to become more familiar. I was in the previous slide also was talking about you become more acquainted with your topic, various aspects, dimensions. Some of those angles probably you might not have thought. And when my research student started about emotional, working on emotional intelligence, she thought as a life skill she would like to start in the very basic proposal of the topic. And then later on she realized it's not just, it is related to your learning. It is related to, it is going to influence your learning outcome, achievement level, adjustment, and so many dimensions. So that makes you too familiar to go ahead with your further research work. All right. So then, effective review of related literature. How you can take up review of related literature effectively? What helps? What requires? Let's look at that. All right. Before I move ahead with this, any questions, queries from your end? Anybody, those who are on live, you'd like to ask a question at this stage? Yes. And the basic concepts are needed importance of review of related literature. You're welcome. And if you can't unmute and talk, if you just type in the chat also, that's fine. We will be taking, I'll be able to take on that. All right, otherwise fine. A little later, I'll get back giving another opportunity to go ahead with. And let's move on with this. All right, we are back. You are able to see this effective review of related literature?
Yes, sir.
Yes. No, it's visible. Let's go ahead. Outlining important research trends. So therefore, it's not that all that research work previously done you are going to bring in here. Only outline important research trends. What is happening in that broad area if you have taken emotional intelligence? Or some other student has been working even now on the teaching English as second language for differently abled children and role of ICT. How ICT influences teaching English to differently abled children, visually challenged, hearing challenged, and these kind of children, how ICT is going to play a role, influence, facilitate, transform, and these are the questions. And then are we going to review all those that are done on differently abled children, ICT, and teaching of English as second language. No, we are not going to bring in all that, but you go through and see the trends, teaching English as second language, how the research works carried out in the last 10 years or a decade before that, or in the 20th century or 21st century beginning. Like that, we are going to bring in the outline important research trends. Then assessing the strengths and weaknesses of existing research. This is important thing. Most of the times, what happens in the name of review of related literature is just reporting, descriptive part of it. Okay, so Reddy and Venkatesh, 1972, in their so and so work has found that this dash. Okay, that is one way, one aspect, one dimension. It is not just that. What needs to also consider to review, to qualify that as an effective or relevant review of related literature is you have to assess the strengths. What is the strength? Is that something related to finding or the methodology or the framework or the variables they have covered or their sampling technique used is unique, is pertinent, is special, does make some value mentioning it? And what are the weaknesses, in the sense limitation, what aspect they did not cover? Not to criticize them, but to understand, to bring in this dimension also can be studied, especially if you are studying that dimension which this previous study did not cover. Be very conscious to make a mention. That what happens in due course, the rationale of your study will be built. Yes, there are studies on emotional intelligence, but this aspect of whose influence on their achievement in bioscience subject, their achievement in co-curricular activities of the school, their achievement in adjustment in the school was not covered. Then now what you are doing? Yes, there is a study which already studied emotional intelligence and academic achievement, but they did not study the bioscience achievement. They have studied something else. They did not study their relevance to the co-curricular, the learner's achievement in co-curricular areas. So like that, when you make mention about the weaknesses or the limitations or the aspects they have and covered, that could be a limitation of the study. We are not criticizing, we are not blaming the researcher who has done the study. As we have identified the strength, the future researchers needs to focus on this, emulate this, follow this. That is the strength, highlighting the strength's purpose. And identifying or assessing the weaknesses purposes, there is a need for the research in this aspect, in this dimension. Okay. Yeah, I could hear somebody saying anything. Somebody want to ask or raise any query? All right. If just by chance, if noise, that's okay. We'll go ahead. Then identifying potential gaps in knowledge. So when you mention the strengths and weaknesses, the potential gaps or needy areas will come out. Establishing a need for current and our future research projects. So that's what the review of related literature is required, and effective review of related literature is going to lead us to. All right. Then what are the important steps in conducting review of related literature? Different books, research methodology books, or the other works or presentations of the scholars, articles, if you refer, will come out with different steps, naming separately, slightly varying, but broadly they fall under five broad aspects. It's not that there are only five steps. I'm not saying that there are five steps in conducting review of related literature, but review of related literature covers, encompasses, includes these five aspects. Number one, planning. Number two, reading and research. Number three, analyzing. Number four, drafting, and finally revising before you present your final thesis. All right, let's go ahead with these steps. Or any questions, queries at this stage? All right, let me visit the chat if there are any questions. Okay, so I have one query. Sir, please discuss about source of literature reviews and how to write literature reviews. Okay, yeah, Mahadev Chattopadhyay, definitely we are going to cover these two aspects as part of this presentation. All right, okay, as we move on, we are going to cover this. Definitely we do come to that point, that is the source of literature reviews and how to write literature reviews. Okay, all right. Okay, here you see the analyzing, drafting at this stage, how to present, and the planning and reading and research at this stage, what other sources also we are going to discuss. All right, it's okay. So let's see stepwise. First step, planning. Develop a list of keywords. This is one important thing. Experienced researchers, of course, they know, but the beginners, particularly those who are with MA education or MA dissertation, or directly somebody kind of joining a PhD without MPhil, probably initially, how do they search is, you give your full topic, type in the Google, and then find out that no matches are found, right? Okay, at this stage, one of you just give me your topic, type in the chat, and I will show how and why it is important to develop list of keywords, or what it is and how to develop list of keywords. Okay, let me minimize this one for a minute for PowerPoint presentation, and I'll be back to, yeah, I'll take one new tab. Before that, anybody gives a topic, you just give me. Otherwise, I have one topic with me. With the help of that, I will go ahead. Meanwhile, even as of now, I did not see anybody typed any research topic on which you are working or you plan or propose to work. Otherwise, I have one topic with me. I'll just take that and go ahead with that. Okay, PhD. Yes. Okay, let me take this topic for now. Yes. Just for your convenience, effect of instructional module in the acquisition of organic, I think chemistry concept, or yeah, chemistry concept. A study of awareness of pupil teacher in inclusive education. All right. Yeah. Chemistry, we got that. But mostly I prefer, it's worth of topic. I have nothing, no issue with this topic. But for now, I prefer to take up this topic. What is it called? A study of awareness of pupil teacher in inclusive education. Before that, the one topic which I have copied, it is ready with me. I'll just post it. It will be ready. A little later, I'll take up this, but now, yes. Nibedita Nayak has given her topic, so I would like to do this with me instead of my topic, which I have done already. And that will become only a demo. But if we do some work with this, probably as I was talking today, we'll practically search so that only sample, of course. You get less than 1%. In advance, I'm saying is, it's not that by the end of the session, you are going to get your substantial review, but you will come to know the sources and the way how you can do your review work. Okay, so I'm just copying this, a study of awareness of pupil teacher in inclusive education. There's the topic ready with the Nibedita. And suppose she goes and type in or copy paste in the Google and then just give. Then what happens? Could see here a study of secondary school teachers Effect of Inclusive Education Awareness Program, Teacher and Parents Awareness. Then title of the paper, here it got some paper, Effect of Inclusive Education Awareness, dash, dash, dash. So like this, so many of this comes. Now, within a 1 second, a fraction of a rather less than a second, you got so many, 1,000,097. So 1,97,00,000, it seems. So many these things. Now, this is the problem. But suppose if the same, you see, if you just put the quotes, hope you are able to see my screen.
Yes, sir.
When I have put the inverted commas, that is quotes, and then research, see what happened. So what here it has took a little longer time, but result says no results found for a study of awareness of pupil teacher in inclusive education. What does this mean? This doesn't mean there is no study at all. As it is same to same ditto title, no reported work is available. Even unreported work that may be there. But always in review of related literature, our concern and scope and limitation of the work is a reported work. If somebody has done and kept in their desk or in their library, and okay, that cannot be reviewed unless it is accessible. So therefore, at least it gives you one thing, same ditto to ditto reported is not there. That's fine. If the same thing has come, you need to be very cautious to thoroughly verify. Is the only title matching same, or along with the title, variables, framework, sample, and all that is matching. You need to see and do. That is a different, the reviewing your scheme of research work. But otherwise, when that it is this, and then at least the number of, now you see a study of secondary school teachers, awareness of teachers of secondary school towards inclusive education. So now relatively better related searches comes. This is one thing. And second, instead the same thing when you want to do, suppose what is this here? Prepare keywords. The first point I was discussing before I get back to this, it was this, develop a list of keywords under the first step in your review of related literature planning, develop a list of keywords. All right, now Nibedita, tell me what could be the keywords for this topic.
Sir, it might be inclusive education.
Yes.
Pupil teacher.
Okay. And awareness, let's take, right?
And three. Awareness, sir.
Yeah, awareness, right. Somebody hinted at. And
yes.
These are the three keywords. Now, let us see. We use only keywords this time. Awareness. Pupil teacher. Inclusive education. And quotes I'm taking off. And now let's see what happens. Effect of Inclusive Education Awareness Program. So at least along with inclusive education, the awareness is also covered. When you give the keywords, this is the advantage. More related will come. Then a study on secondary school teachers, this anyway has come because it has got awareness and inclusive education. Now you see along with the top title, the bottom description you have to see. If some relevant students, look at these keywords and then you are going to go into that. But otherwise, see, even now also you have got some 5,98,00,000. Now that many we can't do review. So therefore, further what to do is, second thing you look here, pupil teacher. These two words is one keyword for us, but when you have like this, wherever the study of teacher, you see here, teachers, awareness of teachers have come. Why teachers have come? It's not the teachers, no, awareness of pupil you are studying. But the top most relevant report kind of thing was reported something awareness of the teachers. Why does this happen? Now, when you have a space like this, two words, pupil, teacher, it consider pupil as one keyword, teacher. Actually, in Nibedita's understanding, she gave three keywords. But in this search understanding, it took five keywords. What are five? Awareness, pupil, teacher, inclusive, education. So it took five. So in order to avoid that, what to do? You can put quotes for this. Which two words to be considered as together? So we want pupil, teacher to be considered as one word. Similarly, inclusive education, this also you want to be considered as inclusive, separate education, separate. No, that's not your idea. So therefore, inclusive education. Now see this time how the results are going to change. Now see, from 5 crores have become 28,400. Now, effect of inclusive education program, still the teacher have come because awareness is there, inclusive education is there. So for these two keywords, it has come. And if you go inside, suppose if it is relevant, probably you may doing further work. Otherwise, at least one thing, the relevance increases with this. The second step under this planning, if you could see here, is use Boolean operators and or not and but not or but not. So when you use this Boolean operators, the chances of more relevant reviews increases. Now let's see how awareness, pupil, teacher, awareness, and what you want? Awareness and pupil, teacher, and inclusive education. And inclusive education. Now you see. Now what happened? Further reduced the studies. 27,500. What happened this time? So it is considering where all these in some form or other, at least two or more are there only, was shortlisted. So this is a second important thing which you need to see. Okay. Now, and we have used awareness, pupil, teacher, inclusive education, but not special education. Not special education. I want reviews related to inclusive education, but not special education or segregated. And here, special education also you have to give in the quotes, but otherwise it considers special as a keyword, education as another keyword. Right. This time it further reduced. Okay. Okay. So this is one thing. And a second thing is, when you say pupil teacher, do you think across the globe or all over India, the word only pupil teacher is used for this? No, right? So another important thing to get more relevant or related reviews to be covered, what other synonyms are used in the industry for this? Okay, now let me take up this for now. A second strategy that can be used and need to be used to come out with most relevant review of related literature is, yes, can you think of instead of pupil teacher, what other terms are familiar, known, used?
Student teacher.
Student teachers. So let me substitute this with the student teacher keyword. And some studies where they have used instead of pupil teacher, student teacher. Now this time it will come.
Teacher trainee.
Yes. Teacher trainee, B.Ed. students, M.Ed. students, M.A. education students. So these all are the possible synonymous words for this. So therefore, what do we do is, you can try with the synonymous word substituting in place of your main keywords. This is another strategy. And the third, suppose some studies related to inclusive education is a recent happening, but not many studies may be there. But instead of inclusive, something related, integrated, special, anyway, we are saying not. If it is special education, awareness about segregated education, no, that is not the scope of this particular study, not that way relevant. But integrated education, because there are cases where people are not really very clear the difference between integrated and inclusive, or might have studied sometime 10 years back, 15 years back, they would have used integrated education and substitute this with this equivalent and then say. And then probably your review is going to change, and then accordingly you can focus more on the relevant. And another dimension is, you see here you have PowerPoint presentations, you have PDF documents, and so on so forth. So therefore, what to do? A second thing is, another way of searching, what you are more interested is in abstracts or research studies, research reports. Give that, and then probably you have a chance of securing more relevant research reports. Or the other alternative is, within the Google, what you have is a Google Scholar. So if you just go to Google Scholar, okay, let us copy this once again, and say Google Scholar. More academic, research based, credible, because otherwise, see, whatever the keyword if you give, some thousands, lakhs, crores are coming. But now what is our focus? It's not anything or any general information, any opinion, but some credible information you want, then probably you can go to Google Scholar and other indexed search resources. Now here it is not only that, more credible information you do get, the additional features you could see here. Are you able to see the screen now?
Yeah, sir.
Okay, great. Now left side of here, you see, anytime, now you have got 2080 here. See, more only relevant, mostly a bit authentic, research-based, publication-based, credible-based will come here. Doesn't mean if it is there in the Google Scholar, it's stamped. No. Chances we are increasing. All right. And then second advantage is, here time you can take only recent studies you want. Just click on this, since 2021. Now what happened? Only recent studies have come. Or no, I just wanted since 2020 or since 2017, or a custom range for last 10 years, 20 years, like this you can hit. And then another thing is, include citations, include patents. And this is also another option it is giving. All right, sort by relevance or sort by date. Date you leave it, and then go for sort by relevance. And again, the other way it will come. So when you go for these kind of academic orientation based sources, you will get best. And especially we are doing from education point of view, and in my personal point of view, without visiting ERIC, E-R-I-C, all right, eric.gov.in, there is one highest good source which normally I visit. I refer, and most of the researchers refer this particular site, ERIC, It's American government-based research site, but it has got very good source of information, and much of the reviews you will be able to get. Let me take a new one and search for Eric. I'll just show you Eric. Yeah, Eric stands for Education Resources Information Center. All right, so click on this. Okay, at the moment some problem is being faced. Otherwise, if you go there, it's going to give you very good relevant information. At the moment there is a problem. Actually, yesterday also I have searched in this as a part of this session preparation also. So what advantage is, only research reports, research based reports and abstracts and all those relevant informations you will be able to get this. All right. Okay. Yeah, somebody gave Eric ed.gov.in. Yes. And let me copy and paste. We'll see. Any change will come. Copy. So there. I believe I have been doing the same. Yeah, same only. That's the site. Just bookmark it. Later you can browse it. Or simply if you are taking note, write down in your notepad. And sometime later you can. It works. It is a working site. At the moment we are facing some problem, but otherwise just note down this link or bookmark this, and that will give you a good source for a revision of this thing, right? It's working on your side. Okay, fine. That's great. And for others' convenience, just note down, and at a little later what happened in my side. Okay, from my end it is facing some problem at the moment. I don't see any block also. There is no block, but some temporary error is coming. There is very good, reliable, relevant, useful information. The only limitation is most of the studies here, being that American based, they collect from various sources, but still abroad studies will be more available. Now the question is, how about the Indian studies? That's where the limitation or the challenge we will come across. All right. Yes, anybody?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Akash, go ahead. If you want to ask something. Akash Kumar. Yes. Momita, would you like to make a point or ask something? No? All right. Yeah, the question is coming to the Indian studies. So honestly admitting, we are recently, situation has improved a lot, but still we are lagging behind, and we are highly conservative in liberally making the contributions available openly to the world, in spite of the best internet sources available with us. That conservative attitude, even after a PhD is awarded, and we will hold it, let me publish my book and then I will publish the papers. At least recognizing this trend, now UGC norm says you should publish two or three articles, depending on university, two or three articles in your area of work. So that's how, from the journals, from magazines, from research articles and other encyclopedias, research abstracts, e-thesis, online thesis, online dissertation reports, online abstracts, and Association of Indian Universities regularly in their journal have been publishing at least month on month what are the research studies awarded as they receive this report. Okay, University News, as you are all familiar with this. So somebody conducting research in education definitely have to review, and probably there you will get only titles, and then you can contact the author, browse this, or these days each university is uploading their abstracts or the thesis online in their university website or library network website. Somehow you will be able to find out that. But otherwise, earlier, as most of us are familiar, we have MB Butch, Survey of Educational Research in Education. Even today for MA dissertations, you can review them, the few of the old studies, because of late, they haven't come with this abstracts, research reviews, but statistics and those things have added up to fourth survey. First, second, third, fourth, up to fourth survey of educational research, 1978 to 85, around that period, regularly under M.B. Butch, this Baroda, M.S. University Baroda Center used to publish on behalf of NCERT, and recent versions are not available, but probably for that you can visit the NCERT website and Shodhagnya and all other online research reports and these theses. All right. Vidya Daini, Mysore based one of the site we have. Just type in Vidya Daini, Google it, otherwise you'll be able to get that source. And there are other sources, but especially what I would like to, which you can't afford to miss, is journals in your subject area. In my case, for example, in the year 98, when I was doing research on learning difficulties, LD. And then definitely journals is an important source. I have visited the Usmania University Library, at least even those days, also one of the known rich source of reviews. And then I could not find a single journal. Then it was a great disappointment, but on the advice of my research supervisor. So another source, human resource, which these days has become mostly the online and friend colleague consultations, but your research supervisor and other experts in your subject area needs to be consulted. And Professor Sudhir Reddy sir, my research supervisor, said, okay, our library does not have a journal on LD. You will have only education and other education, even including NCERT journals, LD publications. You don't get much, but you can visit IFLU library. Then it used to be called CIFL. Now IFLU, English and Foreign Languages Universities. When I went there, I got at least two journals of LD in 1998. I was so happy, but not satisfied. And then I asked, sir, okay, I got some source, but I'm not happy. Then he said, okay, now having you have started some work, now I will tell you the other source. He said, you visit NIMH. Okay, now NIPD, which is called National Institute of Mentally Handicapped at that time, and now it is National Institute of Persons with Intellectual Disabilities. And they have seven journals on LD, Australian Journal of LD, American Journal of LD, like this from different countries and continents. And now you can understand, if a journal itself is on LD, month on month, there are some quarterly, half yearly, at least 3 months, 6 months, I have got a rich source of publications, experts talks, their articles written, and the research reports conducted, and so on and so forth. So there's some of the sources, as one of you have specifically asked, and otherwise is important. All right. So what to do? Coming back to this first step, develop a list of keywords, use Boolean operators and or not, etc. Review before beginning of the research work, during the research work, and at the time of final report preparation. So this is one important point I'd like to emphasize is, please note that review of related literature is not just one-time activity. That 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, even if it is PhD work, if you work for 4 or 5 years, all through, parallel with the other areas of like your tools, collection of data, analysis of data, theoretical framework from the beginning, parallelly one should work on this, because this one important thing can influence all other areas, can give the contribution, can help you to develop further clarity on your work, and so on. So, therefore, plan yourself. Okay, initially, I'm going to collect this, and at later stage, I want to review later stage till your final report is being prepared. All right. And then moving on to the second step, reading and research. So please note that this many articles, thesis, dissertations, reports, journals, can we read? No. I'm not suggesting, or nobody suggests, for the purpose of reviewer related literature to read the whole reports. Rather, what do you prefer? Prefer to read abstracts instead of reports. So in many cases, the reports are available, not the abstracts. At least the latest format suggests, even when you publish a paper, when you publish your report, you should have an abstract. Or otherwise, these sites, they also will give first abstract and then full report. So preferably, I recommend, and it is recommended, to go through the abstract. When you find abstract is relevant, related to your research work, yes, you have some point in that where you can review. You need to go into details. Only then, if required, you can go into it. Yeah, I could hear somebody. Was there any questions, query? You can take an opportunity. I'll go ahead from this point later. Yes. Okay. If there is no question, let's go ahead. Yeah.
What's the difference between the abstracts and reports?
Yeah. Report is the full length, and abstract is a small version of summary of it. Like if you publish your report in the form of article, still it is anywhere 4 to 12 pages, 15 pages. But abstract is mostly one paragraph, maximum half page. All right?
Okay, so thank you.
The abstract gives you, in this particular research work, the researcher worked on so-and-so topic, so-and-so area, tool or methodology, framework, sample, briefly, one or two findings. They will be mentioning. Now, that will give you an idea whether you need to go further. Otherwise, okay, it's not having much relevance. That's simply you can skip it. Thus, you can save some time. Okay. All right. Yeah. Then identify most relevant reviews. So when you read abstract first, you are shortlisting. Okay. You are identifying most relevant reviews. Then collecting or using the reviews reported in others' reports thesis. Now, this is one of the fundamental questions which involves some research ethics as well. Suppose on the relevant topic, similar topic, somebody else already did the research and they have presented, they have one chapter on review of related literature. For example, now let us take the example of the one inclusive education. Just now she has an opinion of the pupil teachers. Now, student teachers or pupil teachers or the B.Ed. students, M.Ed. students or teacher education students, like this with the various titles, somebody might have conducted their opinion on inclusive education. Definitely in their report, they have a unit on this reviews. They have done so many reviews. Can I simply copy paste them for my research purpose? Yes. Can someone do so or not? No. So mostly it is done. I understand that. But suppose there are 2-3 dangers. Why it should not be? I'm saying, sir, that's going to be a very big, difficult task. Yeah, it's going to be a difficult task, but you can. You can take it from there, but not directly as it is copy-paste kind of the thing. Now you can take, when they have referred, they will also will give you the source, right, in the bibliography. Go to that source, view it, and you can choose it from your own study point of view. Because of their title, their objectives, their variables they are covering in their study, they might have chosen that particular review. And now, though you take the same, because your objectives differ, your variables differ, or your methodology differs, so you need to take, you can visit the source for two reasons. Number one, then it will become more relevant to your study. Number two, you will be more confident and authentic and genuine work. Such study is not there. Somewhere he found and he has written, and there is no reference is given at the end. And you have copied and pasted. Somebody at the stage of Viva or some other, your seminar presentation stage, points out at this. What is its source? And then there is no source and it is not authentic. And then your review will become a questionable review. So therefore, yes, you take the hint from that. Oh, so-and-so person worked on this. Variables are the findings in any review of literature. We mentioned one or two relevant to our study, right? Now, if you go to the original source, what happens? You can choose the findings or the variables or the methodology, which to highlight, which to find, point out the gap, all that you'll be doing from your work. So it is always desirable you visit the original source and then prepare the review from your own point of view of study, in your own words preferably. All right?
Good evening, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
So there is one question.
Okay.
So can I ask?
Yeah, please.
Sir, so if we do review of any topic, suppose I am not getting the exact topic which I have made for my dissertation or thesis. So can I review some similar topics associated with it? Can it be mentioned in my dissertation?
Yes, you can. But when I was discussing about keywords, that's what I was discussing, right? When you identified three keywords, for example, let me cite back this example given by which we have.
Sorry, sir, I joined late.
Ah, okay. So you will understand. Anyway, recorded version will be available. Go through
okay,
it.
Okay, sir.
And still you have a question, you can raise it. But the point is, when you make keywords, suppose in the one search which we have made here, we have made inclusive education, pupil teacher awareness. Now, pupil teacher awareness, inclusive education awareness. Awareness of the pupil teachers should be about inclusive education. If it's not about inclusive education, awareness of the pupil teachers about innovative methods of teaching, making that as a review, no meaning. But awareness of the pupil teachers about inclusive education.
So that means some similar thing should be there. Not
yes. If not all the keywords, all the variables are covered, still you can take. That's the reason we say review of related literature. It's not the same. It's related. So you can.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
You can but see that relevance. That's it. The note underlying. Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yes. All right. Then choose contents from the point of view of your study. Then noting the source of information for referencing. This is another important. The beginning researchers, most of the times, they go on collecting, but anyway, it's available on internet. I'll come back anytime. No, please note that. What is there today on internet need not necessarily be there tomorrow. Eric 24/7 is accessible at the moment. At my end, I am not able to assess. It doesn't mean it's not there, but individual reviews, reports, abstracts, sometimes they may be removed by the author. They may be removed by the particular site managers. So many things happen. So therefore, the day you come across, if you feel it is even, I will consider it later stage, note down the its referencing. That is important. Because as you know, inevitably, whenever you quote something, authentic source must be given in bibliography, especially your review of related literature. People will see by name, there are contexts where in a thesis, your second chapter review of related literature names and authentic studies you have mentioned and the bibliography will be cross-checked. in my knowledge, some universities have this practice even before accepting the thesis for submission. So therefore, from the beginning, you go on building this, and it is going to help you at the end. Third point, analyzing. Yes. Now, normally, if you look at many reviews, it appears like, okay, so-and-so studied this and found this. So-and-so studied this, found this. So-and-so studied this, found this. Yes, that is acceptable, but there is one type of review called descriptive. But it's your review of related literature, particularly if it is at PhD level, is not acceptable, cannot be limited only for descriptive. Not just descriptive, but analyze the information collected. Analyze from what point of view? From the point of view of the tools they used, method they followed, variables they covered, findings pertinent, limitations. From whatever the point of view you think from your study it has got a relevant, do that, and that's going to make comprehensive and meaningful. In order to arrive at such analysis and synthesis, what to do? You ask and answer pertinent questions. Does this study anyway concerned about inclusive education? Yes. Is that anyway also covered or involved pupil teachers, student teachers, in pre-service teachers, teacher education, students? And that is not, then you should rethink once again. All right. So therefore, ask pertinent questions, analyze, synthesize, and before you finally choose it and go ahead. All right. Okay. So a few more things I would like to give you. What to do at this level, particularly especially for higher level of PhD, or if you are writing a research based paper, definitely just a descriptive you give is not going to be considered as authentic or highly useful. So what to do? Probably what you can do is you just point out what is the strength of that particular study? What is the innovativeness in their methodology? What is the uniqueness, if any? What is the relevance of those findings to the field? If they have brought any policy decisions in the field, if they have suggested any innovative practices, for example, the constructivist theory has brought in recently so many. So therefore, does that particular framework based on any theory, established theory, which is in practice in the system? And from all those point of view, you can do. All right. And then reporting the review. Now, finally, it comes when you are reporting. How do we report the review? So you all know, but there are few important commonly followed strategies I would like to tell you, which you see year-wise, right? Chronological order. Find latest one in the beginning. If you are using chronological, preferably latest reviews in the beginning and then the older one. But always it doesn't suit. It's though it is one of the acceptable way of reporting or presenting your reviews, it is not always preferable or desirable. If your study of research is something to do with the chronological order, historical evolution of Indian education with reference to the pedagogic practices, yes, best option, you can go by chronological order. But otherwise, what you can do method wise suppose use of innovative strategies in teaching. So what are the different innovative strategies? Or otherwise we call it as theme or topic wise. So if your topic, for example, let's go back to this. Nibedita, I remember. Topic, inclusive education. So then what you can do? You can have reviews related to pupil teachers awareness. Reviews related to practices in inclusive education. reviews related to awareness of teachers about inclusive education. Because if you don't find, if you are doing at a PhD level, if you don't find sufficient number of reviews after searching with the keywords pre-service, in-service, teacher education, B.Ed, M.Ed, teacher education students, still you don't find, what do you do is anyway, teachers awareness. Awareness of teachers towards inclusive education. Then you have to make a mention that the study carried out, found out the awareness of the teachers, but it is in-service teachers. So therefore, in the current study, pre-service teachers awareness is taken up. That way you can mention the other, where you are talking about the need and importance of the study or the rationale for the study. Up to here, this current study have covered awareness of teachers about inclusive education, but with reference to in-service teachers. All right. So therefore, not always chronological. Along with the chronological, topic-wise or the theme-wise or the methodology used for the study, whether qualitative study, quantitative studies, and also you will find national or international studies. If you have many Indian studies and abroad studies, if you want to arrange that way also is acceptable. Well, within that you see that either chronological or topic-wise or methodology-wise, also you have been classifying. All right. Okay. Yeah, we have already come at 7:15, and before I conclude, I have 2-3 things to suggest and say of this part of it before we move on to the sample selection and sampling. And from your end, any questions, queries, now it is open for the questions and discussion. Let me stop presenting.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hello.
Kanchan.
Hello.
Yeah, Kanchan, we could hear you. Please go ahead. If I pronounce it properly, otherwise Kanchan Sarkar.
The basic of review of literature and review of related data. So this is the answer. What is basic data?
Sorry, Kanchan, I love to take your question and interact, but audio is breaking. Can I request you to type it in the chat? Either I'll take directly or our team members will read it for us and we will go ahead.
Okay,
yeah, please do type it in the chat. Yes. Meanwhile, any other questions, queries?
Hello, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
So there is one question, sir. In the dissertation, when we do the review of various topics, like of other generals and dissertation, so when we gone to write it in a order-wise, firstly we write the theme. That suppose the you were talking about the inclusive education awareness of inclusive education. So now suppose someone has done in a qualitative way, then firstly we will mention the theme, then the objective, then related with that methodology. Answer can be also mention the data collected. We should mention there or not, or just write the gist of the reference. But sir, I want to ask, what is the correct way to write it? Like when I have written in my MEd, I have also included the like this much data collected and methodology to use was this. Like just I have mentioned everything when I have written in my dissertation, sir, review. So what is the correct way to write? Should we mention the main things that we use in our proposal that we should include or not? How we should write that? So please guide.
All right. One clarification before I answer, I want to ask you is data collected, you mean the sample? You mentioned about the sample or the values like mean or something like the data?
That's a data collected. Like I have done experimental research in my dissertation. Then 90 students I have taken, suppose. Okay. Then that I mentioned that 90 students from this school I have taken. Then this methodology, quantitative research was used.
then further, which sampling technique was used? These things that I'm asking, suppose someone do the research in a big way, then what they do, they use a quantitative and qualitative books, mixed research. Then there they mention the whole process, like factorial design also they are using, like it become a big research, which we have to review in a long way process. So that how we can conclude it, so that's the main issue.
Got the point. Number one, as far as sample tools, method of research used, findings they got, variables they covered. Of course, basically title, author, anyway, we will mention. The rest of all can be mentioned, but there is no hard and fast rule. You must mention all this. You should not mention this. Then what to mention, what need not to be mentioned is, if you think there is a similarity between your current study and their study with reference to method of study or the finding or the sample selection, you mention that. Or second context where you have to mention, it is desirable to mention, is if you think that is unique. They have conducted a survey to find out the opinion of the teachers about awareness about inclusive education. Then making survey method is used, separate mention not required. Just in this abstract part of it, reporting it has come, it's okay. But suppose if they have used an innovative, they have used a focus group discussion to understand the awareness of the student teachers with regard to inclusive education, then specifically you will be mentioning. So therefore, they can be mentioned in the context, one, if there is any similarity or if it is there any uniqueness or as a limitation of the study you want to highlight or a research gap. So if it indicates research strength, research limitation, research similarity, then it makes sense to mention, right? I hope that answers your query.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
All right. There is a question Kanchan Sarkar wants to ask. What is the basic difference, review of literature and review of related literature? All right. So probably review of related literature and review of literature are similar in one sense. But the simple thing is your review of literature is vast, unlimited. Anything related to the research in your broader area. But when we talk of review of related literature, related to your topic, your specific area of the study, and in either MA dissertation, MA, PG or PhD dissertation, what we will do is review of related literature. And the review of literature is done by those research publications, like your abstract or indexing or encyclopedias, those kind of people. For the purpose of research, what we will do is review of related literature, those studies in that relevant specific area of your research. All right. Otherwise, your review of literature is oceans, and review of related literature, let us see, in Indian context, Indian Ocean. That's all. You are pertinent to this geographical area of study. All right. So before I conclude this session, as we have meant, this is also for the sample and sampling. As you are all aware, once your topic is decided, something like this, student teachers awareness about inclusive education. Now, when you go inside, in the title, we'll not be writing inside, Nivedita might have mentioned that in so and so district, and all the student teachers in that district, as you are aware, is known as population. Now, when she mentions also under her methodology, for the present study, 100 student teachers, if it is a dissertation level, or a 300 or 500 student teachers, if it is a PhD level, mentions that are going to be covered, and that becomes the sample. But again, which method do you use? Either random or non-random, stratified, and so on and so forth. All this theoretically will be available. At the moment, if you have a topic in your mind, either with regard to population or the sample selection, you have any specific queries, you can ask and we will go ahead. Before I invite that, there are one or two questions in the chat. I will answer them and I will get back to that. Okay. How many review of related literature should be written in chapter one introduction part? Jyoti Verma, please note that there is no rule. It should be in chapter one or it should be a separate chapter. And also there is no hard and fast rule. 50, 100, 20, 30 reviews should be covered. No, there is no hard and fast rule, but there is one thing which one must follow or keep in mind while doing review of related literature. It must be comprehensive. When the word comprehensive includes what? In period of time, you just can't take only reviews of 2020, 2021 and mine is comprehensive. So depending on your topic, at least last 5 years, 10 years, 15, 20 years, depending on the topic, should be covered over a period of time. This is one, time reference comprehensiveness. Second, it must cover all the variables. May not be same study will be covering all the variables. But for example, if I refer back the same study, if I take only inclusive education and awareness, it's not comprehensive. Only student teachers awareness is not comprehensive. So all the variables, as far as the current study is proposing, must be covered, except any one variable reviews are not available or not available many, that's okay. Where more available, more studies. Where less studies are only available, you can have less number of covered. Not equally on three variables out of 30, 10 on pupil teachers, 10 covering awareness, 10 covering inclusive education. Not like that. But end of the review, when somebody goes through, yes, all the three variables are covered. Okay. All okay, right. Similarly, as similar question pertinent to sample also, same thing. The last time also when we have discussed that there is no fixed hard and fast rule. Because if it is student teachers, 100, 500 also you will get. If it is special educators, opinion, awareness of special educator about inclusive education, then getting 100 is also big deal. So in that case, so statistically 30 plus is large sample. That doesn't mean 30 plus is a very good enough. No. In some cases, 50 is grossly insufficient. In some cases, 50 is a good enough sample. So it depends on what is the size of your population and the sample. Except in exceptional cases, a 1 to 10% of the population will be a good sample size. Not hard and fast rule. When I say student teachers or pupil teachers in your state. Now in your state, probably there are 1 lakh, let us say. Even if I say 1%, that is 1,000. Does it mean you should take minimum 1,000 sample? No, not necessarily. Still, if you take 400, 500 is also okay. So therefore, it's not to say that as a rule, as I said, there is no thumb rule, a hard and fast rules, but should be representative. As far as the sample is concerned, it should be representative of the population. Because ultimately, these results we are going to generalize to the population. The awareness of this 100 students you have selected, you are going to generalize as related to that 1 lakh. So therefore, instead of 100, 300, 500 you will take. Within that also you will see B.Ed, M.Ed, D.Ed level, urban, rural, if there is a medium, if there is management, all these variables are to be covered. Then we say it is comprehensive and representative. So your sample must be comprehensive in coverage and representative to the population. So that much I can say. All right. All right. So there is another question from Ritu. How do we review any chapter of the book or a book? Example, a chapter on drama method in ESL or a book on the theory of mind. How do we find the exact main ideas or relevant points from the book? All right. Now, one thing is, if you think the book is relevant to your topic, yes, you can do the review. But what do you do is, like, go through the chapters. Within the book, not all the chapters might have been relevant to your topic. Mm-hmm. Identify those topics. And within that topics, give a bird's eye view. Take some side notes or point main points. And then probably you'll be able to come out with the relevant review of that. Okay. Sir, what is the difference between cluster sampling and quota sampling? Quota sampling, you are focusing on the number. When I say 100, till 100 candidate is covered, I'm going to take on. And cluster sampling is related to the geographic. Slum area, for example. Opinion of the slum dwellers in Hyderabad about accessibility of preschool education facility for their children. And then I'm going to select some clusters of slums. Now I'm going to go there and take their opinion. But in that case, if I'm using a quota sampling and says my sample is 100, the 100 people come in one cluster, two clusters, three cluster, I go on. In first cluster, my 100 is not covered. I'll go to second cluster, third cluster also. So this one quota sampling refers to the number, and cluster sampling refers to the geographical dispersion availability of the respondents identified for sampling. All right. Sir, there is a question from Rashi. Sir, in review of related literature, it should be written in para-wise, or we can write in a point also. And if we want to mention our suggestions and limitations over there, can we mention? Okay. Point one is, normally we do write and preferable and desirable to write in a paragraph descriptive manner when you are reviewing. But under that, it has covered the following three important objectives. Now, those three you can have a number or bulleted. It has come out with the following two significant findings related to the current study among the others, one and two. Like that, you can mention. All right. Okay. And coming to the suggestions and limitations. Suggestions and limitations mentioned by the researcher, you can mention there. But if you have any of your suggestions, we are not supposed to give any suggestions as far as the review of related study is concerned. From the point of view of your study, you may give suggestions and conclusions at appropriate place, either fourth or fifth chapter or end chapters. But you can identify, mention the strengths and limitations of that study in your words. That can be done. But we will not, the researcher would have conducted this study involving a large sample. No, you should not give such suggestion. But you can say the same study may be conducted with a large sample, which is one of the limitations of the present study. And future studies may can take up this. That probably aptly identifying the strength or limitation or research gap, you can mention. All right. No criticizing or evaluating remarks. Identifying the strengths and the future prospects or possibilities of research are welcome. All right. Okay. Yeah, it's already 7:33. Let's find out if we can I take some more questions, because there are questions in the chat, or it's time to conclude, and later on you can forward these questions. We can respond also.
Sir, a question hai mera.
Akash, boliye. Now I can hear you properly.
Jab hum log research karte hain, to kabhi kabhi research shunya ho jata hai. To research shunya na ho, kuch na kuch output mile. Iske liye hum kya kar sakte hain, sir?
One word I have missed. After doing research, what happened? Akash, you said something missed. I could not get that word.
Sir, jab kabhi kisi topic ko lekar jab hum research karte hain, to research karne ke baad uska jo output jo positive way mein kuch research point hona chahiye, wo nahi milta, wo research shunya ho jata hai.
Okay. Output, expected output hasn't met. Your output expected is not reached. I understand it from you have hypothesized and your hypothesis is not proved, right? Your hypothesis hasn't become true.
Yes,
please,
sir.
Please note that as a researcher, hypothesis is only a statement, tentative statement. Can be accepted or can be rejected. If it is not proven based on your research data, if you have followed proper methodology and nothing, even if it is in contrary to the previous findings, you have to report it as it is. Or if you think something went wrong in my population, our tools, our collection of data, then go back and review that. But otherwise, yes, I have followed objectively. This is the outcome and just reporting that. Because research doesn't aim proving or disproving anything. Reporting what is found out. So therefore, we just report as it is. Yes, Dhananjay, I could see you are trying to say something. You can take a turn now. All right. Meanwhile, I'll take up this question from TESS. Please let us know. Yeah, Alisha, I'm taking your Elena Mishra. Yeah, Elena, you want to ask? You can ask.
Anyway, I'm sir, good evening, sir.
Yeah. Yes, Elena, go ahead.
Yes, sir. Sir, in a topic, a study of attitude of learners towards technology-based learning, what can be the variables and objectives and how many samples we have to take?
Okay. All right. Elena, please note that variables I can see looking at this title, your attitude of learners and the technology. A study on the attitude of learners towards technology. Attitude of the learners towards technology is one dependent variable. Independent, probably you can take their age, their education level, parental background, family background, and so on and so forth. Unless I know your sample, what is the sample, I will not be able to mention about the other variables. And anyway, the second question you have asked, sir, how many samples? So who are your population? What is your population or the...
Yes, sir. Sir, I want to study on the students of, means the second, sorry, high school level, 6th to 10th. Because now due to the pandemic, they are shifted to the online education. So what are their attitudes towards the technology-based learning and how they are... Yes, sir.
Now got the point. Now please do add that in your title, a study of attitude of secondary school students towards technology-based learning. And then the attitude of secondary school students towards technology-based learning is one dependent variable. You can go all independent variable like the class they are studying, the platform of LMS they are using for study, the gadgets they are using, facilities available at home, parental cooperation, their awareness or orientation given to the children, supervising mechanisms, all these can be the other variables. Just list out and depending on your study, after discussion with your research supervisor, you can finalize. Right?
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome. All right. I hope it's time to conclude now.
Sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, how many samples we can take? 20, 30 or more?
Is it for M.Ed dissertation or...
yes, sir. M.Ed, sir. I am doing integrated B.Ed, M.Ed in RI Bhopal.
Secondary school students, at least 50 to 100, depending on your availability. Better.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. I think you have taken all the questions that are in the chat box. Okay, sir. So... I would like to invite you to summarize your topic in a very brief, sir.
All right. We have seen today about review of related literature, starting from why it is important, and apart from being a part of your dissertation work, how it is also going to be useful for you at the stage of understanding more about your topic, getting clarity on your theoretical framework, review, methodology, and current status of the work in your field, and the gap and need and importance for your current study. From all these point of view, it will work. So therefore, you can plan for your review of related literature from 5 stages, like basic planning, what are the sources, how you are going to collect your reviews, and then what are the online and offline techniques you are going to use, and finally, how do you report, how do you choose and report in that. And the second also, we just had an outline of population and sample. So therefore, sample should be representative to the population. So depending on that, the level of study, purpose of study, if it is only for a seminar research purpose you are doing, even a 30-40 also will do. Or experts and unique, rarely available sample, in that case, even a 10-20 also may be considered. But for PhD research work, definitely we'll look a comprehensive and representative. Again, that's the important word, comprehensive, covering all variables, representative, covering all if substrata, subgroups, sub areas of the population to be covered in the sample. So thus, anywhere 50 to 100 at dissertation level and 100 to 500 at a PhD level, depending on the sample, will be a reasonable 1 to 10%. But all these numbers are only suggestive. They are not fixed. No hard and fast rule. How many reviews should be there? How many sample to be taken? In both the cases, it should be relevant, comprehensive, representative. Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir. Session was very much practical, as you put did it practically. Now I would like to invite our chief coordinator of this LOD session, Mr. Shambhunath Upadhyay. He is technical expert of our community also, and you can say he is backbone of our community. So I welcome Mr. Shambhunath, sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you for inviting me, ma'am. First of all, I would like to thank everyone who joined. And apart from that, a special thank to Dr. Yakia, sir. I have been listening to him for the past 3 or 4 months, and I am very much inspired by him. Today, sir, you told us about what to review and when to review, kab kab review karna, har stage par review karna hai, and then what not to review. It was also included in the topic of the discussion, how to find relevant study, the Boolean thing on Google, how to sort it out effectively, and how to report the reviews. It was also covered by you, sir. And in the sample discussion about the sample, you told us about it should be comprehensive and it should be representative of the population. And this is what I learned, and I guess this is what everyone must have learned. And apart from that, we will be posting the recorded session today only, and you can avail from the YouTube channel. And I am very much thankful to Yakia, sir, for enlightening us. And currently, we are going to start the research and publication unit. It's going to be fully functional. And Yakia, sir, we will be asking you questions frequently for that research and publication unit.
Right. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
And you're welcome. We'll be happy to serve our community. We are there for that purpose.
Over to you, ma'am. Smita, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Shambhu, sir. Now, I would like to invite Ms. Kirti Singh, ma'am, for the formal vote of thanks. Over to you, ma'am.
यस यस मैम आई थिंक शंभू सर ने काफ़ी कुछ बोल दिया है सर आपके लिए मुझे लगता है सर, धन्यवाद कि आपने सच में इतना कीमती समय हमारे साथ साझा किया। सर, रिव्यू ऑफ लिटरेचर एक ऐसा विषय है जिसके लिए हम हमेशा कंफ्यूज रहते हैं, लेकिन आपने सभी कंफ्यूजन को दूर करते हुए और भी अतिरिक्त जानकारियां हमें दी। सर, आपने क्यों और कैसे का आंसर देते हुए सभी स्टेपों की बखूबी चर्चा की। सर, आपने जिस तरह हमें एग्जाम्पल लेते हुए समझाया, वाकई काबिल तारीफ है। तो थैंक यू सो मच सर, थैंक यू सो सो मच। और मैं धन्यवाद करना चाहती हूँ इस ग्रुप के प्रमुख डॉक्टर सोमू सिंह सर का कि आपने हमें एक प्लेटफॉर्म दिया जहाँ हम रोज कुछ न कुछ नया सीख रहे हैं। मैं धन्यवाद करना चाहती हूँ चीफ कोऑर्डिनेटर मिस्टर सचिन वर्मा सर का, और मैं समस्त तकनीकी प्रबंधन टीम का भी धन्यवाद करना चाहती हूँ। एंड स्पेशल थैंक टू स्मिता मैम एंड शंभू सर, आई थिंक यू टू आप दोनों ही हमारी रीढ़ की हड्डी हैं। तो थैंक यू सो मच, एंड थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सो मच।
थैंक यू कीर्ति मैम। तो आई नाउ फॉर्मली अनाउंस द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन। प्लीज बी इन टच विद अस, we will definitely organize, we will inform the next structure when it is organized. Thank you, sir, thank you all.